Good morning, students. In last lecture, we have discussed about the definition of vector space. Now, we solve some examples of vector space. So, the first example is check whether V is a vector space or not. Where what is the V? V is equal to set of all order pair XY, where XY belongs to R. So, V is R2 space. This is R2 space. If here is x, y, z, then it is R3 space. Here it is 2 tuple. If it is 3 tuple, then it is called R3 space. If here it is n tuple, then it is called Rn space. So, in binary operation defined as x1, y1 plus x2, y2 is equal to x1, y1. And for alpha belongs to R, alpha x1, alpha into x1 y1 is equal to alpha x1 comma alpha y1. So now our aim is to prove V is a vector space or not. So first we check commutative property. Let U bar is equal to 1, order pair 1 2 belongs to V, and V bar is equal to 2, 3 belongs to V. Vector 1, 2, we can say it as a vector 1, 2 or vector 2, 3. Then U bar plus V bar is equal to 1, 2 plus vector 2, 3 is equal to 1, 2. Because our definition binary operation is x1, y1. So here x1 is 1 and y1 is 2. Similarly, V bar plus U bar is equal to 2, 3 plus 1, 2 is equal to x1 is 2, y1 is 3. Now, U bar plus V bar is equal to 1, 2 and V bar plus U bar is equal to vector 2, 3. Both are not same. So, U bar plus V bar does not equal to V bar plus U bar. So, symmetric property is not satisfied. This implies that V is not vector space. Here we get, now if it is not vector space because symmetric property is not satisfied. If it's satisfied and some other property is not satisfied, then it is also not a vector space. To be a vector space, all of the properties which are in definition must be satisfied. If any one of these properties cannot satisfy, then given set is not vector space with given binary operation. If we change the binary operation, then it may be possible that V is the vector space. Now, second example, check whether V is a vector space or not. Where V is R2 space and 2 vector x, y, z, w belongs to R2 and alpha belongs to R, binary operation defined as follow. Now, binary operation is x, y plus z, w is equal to x plus z, y plus w, and alpha dot x, y is equal to alpha x, y. Now, our aim is to prove given set is a vector space or not with given binary operation. So let us consider alpha is equal to 1, beta is equal to 2. Here alpha connect, alpha multiplied only with x. So it is obvious that this is not binary operation. Not vector space. So how to prove? So let us consider particular example. Let alpha is equal to 1, beta is equal to 2 and x bar is equal to 1, 1. Now alpha plus beta x bar is equal to 1 plus 2 vector 1, 1 is equal to 3, 1, 1. 1 plus 2 is equal to 3 multiplied with vector 1, 1 is equal to. Now the binary operation defined is alpha x, y. So alpha multiply only the first coordinates. So 3 multiply only the first coordinate, not second coordinate. So 3 into 1 is equal to 3 and it remain as it is. So alpha plus beta x bar, we get the answer 3, 1. Now alpha x bar plus beta x bar is equal to 1 multiplied with vector 1, 1, and 2 multiplied with vector 1, 1. Now from binary operation, alpha multiplied only with the first coordinate, so 1, 1 as it is, and 2 multiplied only with first coordinates, so we get the 2, 1. So we get the answer 3, 2. Hence alpha plus beta x bar, we get the answer 3, 1, and alpha x bar plus beta x bar, we get the answer 3, 2. So both are not same, so this property is not satisfied. This property is the distributive over scalar addition is not satisfied. Hence, V is not vector space with given binary operation. It may possible that if we change the binary operation, then given set V may be the vector space. Now, example number 3. Let V is equal to set of all XY, where X greater than 0, Y greater than 0, and XY belongs to R. And for alpha belongs to R, AB, vector AB and vector CD belongs to V. Binary operation defined as follow: AB plus CD is equal to vector AC, vector BD. And alpha scalar multiplication defined as follow: alpha multiplied with vector AB gives the answer vector A raised to alpha, B raised to alpha. Now our aim is to check whether V is the vector space or not. Now if V is vector space then it must satisfy all these properties in the definition. So first is the closure property for the vector addition. So let consider two vector AB and CD belongs to V. Now AB and CD belongs to V. So from the given set V, if XY belongs to V, then X greater than 0, Y greater than 0. Here AB, vector AB and vector CD belongs to V. So A greater than 0, B greater than 0, C greater than 0 and D greater than 0. Now A and C both are greater than 0. So multiplication of A and C is also greater than 0. Similarly B and D both are greater than 0. So multiplication of B and D is also greater than 0. So AB, vector AB plus vector CD is equal to AC, BD belongs to V as AC greater than 0 and BD greater than 0. And also the multiplication AC belongs to R and BD belongs to R. Now second is, so closure property is satisfied. Now second is commutative property. So what is the commutative property? Vector AB plus vector CD is equal to vector AC BD. Now multiplication of real number is commutative. So AC is equal to CA, we can write BD is equal to DB. So ACBD is equal to vector CADB. Now of CABD can be written as CD plus AB from the definition of binary vector addition. This is the definition of vector addition. So we can move from right hand side to left hand side. Here CADB, so we get CD and second coordinate is AB. Clear? So commutative property is also satisfied. Now third is associative property. So associative property, we get the three vector AB, CD and EF. So first is first bracket vector AB plus vector CD and third vector is outside. So vector AB plus vector CD, we get the answer AC first coordinate, second coordinate. So AC comma BD and plus EF. Now the vector addition defined as follow: first coordinate of first vector, first coordinate of second vector, and multiplication of these two coordinate. So AC multiplied with E and BD multiplied with F. Now multiplication in R is associative. So AC multiplied with E, A multiplied with CE, and B multiplied with DF. Here C is, here this is the counts, okay, this is round bracket, not C. Here it is C, it is round bracket. So A multiplied with CE and B multiplied with DF. Now first coordinate can, now convert it into the vector addition. So we get vector AB plus vector CE DF. So we get the answer vector AB plus vector, now again convert it into the vector addition form. So vector AD plus vector CD plus vector EF. So associative property is also satisfied. Now fourth is the existence of identity element. So what is the identity element? If when we add any vector from the given set, we get the same answer. So for all AB belongs to V, we have theta is equal to 1, 1, vector 1 belongs to V such that vector AB plus theta is equal to vector AB plus vector 1, 1. Now vector addition is first element multiplied with first element, second coordinate multiplied with second coordinate. So we get the answer A comma B. So we have consider n vector AB, then we get the n multiply take addition with vector theta, then we get the same answer as AB. So theta is equal to 1, 1 is identity element. So existence term identity element is satisfied. Now existence of inverse element. Now if we consider any vector AB belongs to V, then from the definition A greater than 0, B greater than 0. So this implies then 1 upon A also greater than 0, 1 upon B also greater than 0. AB belongs to R, so 1 upon A, 1 upon B also belongs to R. So 1 upon A comma 1 upon B also belongs to V. So first we saw that 1 upon A and 1 upon B belongs to V. Now consider vector AB from V. We have vector 1 upon A comma 1 upon B belongs to V such that vector addition of these two vector, we get the answer identity element. How? So consider the vector addition of AB and vector 1 upon A comma 1 upon B. So vector AB plus vector 1 upon A comma 1 upon B. Now vector addition defined as first coordinate multiplied with first coordinate of first vector, second coordinate of first vector multiplied with second coordinate of second vector. So A multiplied with 1 upon A, B multiplied with 1 upon B. We get the answer 1, 1. This is the identity element. So inverse element exists for every element in V. So fifth property is also satisfied. Now this five property is for the vector addition. Now the last five property is for the scalar multiplication. So the first property is for scalar multiplication, means six properties, closer property for the scalar multiplication. If we consider any element, any vector AB belongs to V, we have AB belong A greater than 0, B greater than 0, and AB belongs to R. Now consider alpha belongs to R. Then A raised to alpha is also greater than 0, B raised to alpha is also greater than 0, and A raised to alpha, B raised to alpha belongs to R. So the vector A raised to alpha, comma B raised to alpha belongs to vector space, sorry, V, set V. This implies that alpha, scalar multiplication of alpha with vector AB also belongs to V. Hence, the closure property for scalar multiplication is satisfied. Now, seventh property is alpha beta of U bar. We get the answer alpha beta of U bar. So, let us consider alpha beta belongs to R and vector U bar belongs to V. Now, alpha multiplied with beta of U bar is equal to alpha multiplied with beta U bar is equal to vector AB. Now, from the definition binary operation scalar multiplication alpha, first, now here the scalar is move on the power. So, alpha A raised to beta B raised to beta is equal to, now alpha is again move on to power, A raised to beta raised to alpha, B raised to beta raised to alpha. Now, here we get the multiplication of these two powers. So, A raised to beta alpha, B raised to beta alpha. Now, multiplication is associative. So, we can write as A raised to alpha beta, B raised to alpha beta. Now, again, write this vector in form of scalar multiplication. So, we get the answer alpha beta vector AB is equal to alpha beta of U bar. So, this property is also satisfied. Now, eighth property is distributivity over vector addition, or we can say that scalar multiplication is distributive over vector addition. For that, let us consider alpha belongs to R and two vector U bar and V bar belongs to V, where U bar is equal to AB, vector AB, and vector V bar is equal to vector CD. Now, distributivity over vector addition means alpha U bar plus V bar is, we get the answer alpha U bar plus alpha V bar. So, we start with alpha U bar plus V bar. Now, alpha U bar is equal to vector AB and V bar is equal to vector CD. Now, here we get the vector addition. So, alpha first coordinate multiplied with first coordinate, we get the answer vector AC, vector BD. Now, binary operation scalar multiplication, here scalar move on to the power. So, we get AC raised to alpha, comma BD raised to alpha. Now, power is distributive over each number. So, we get A raised to alpha, C raised to alpha, and B raised to alpha, D raised to alpha. Now, again, apply the definition of vector addition. We get A raised to alpha, comma B raised to alpha, C raised to alpha, comma D raised to alpha. Now, again, apply the definition of scalar multiplication. Alpha move here, so we get alpha vector AB plus alpha vector C, comma D. So, this is the alpha of U bar and alpha of V bar. So, alpha U bar plus V bar, we get the answer alpha U bar plus alpha V bar. So, distributivity over vector addition is satisfied. Now, this is the distributivity over scalar addition. Here it is distributivity over vector addition. Now, here it is distributivity over scalar addition. For that, consider alpha beta belongs to R and vector U bar is equal to AB belongs to V. So, alpha plus beta U bar is equal to alpha plus beta vector U bar is equal to AB. Now, this here scalar move on to the power of each coordinate. So, A raised to alpha plus beta comma b raised to alpha plus beta. Now here it is the addition of power, so it can be written as a raised to alpha multiplied with a raised to beta, and b raised to alpha multiplied with b raised to beta. Now apply the definition of vector addition. So first element and first element, a raised to alpha b raised to alpha, plus second element comma second element, a raised to beta comma b raised to beta. So now again apply the definition of scalar multiplication, alpha of AB plus beta of vector AB is equal to alpha u bar plus alpha u bar plus beta u bar. So distributivity over scalar addition is also satisfied. Now last property is unit vector. This means that when we multiplied any vector with 1, then we get the same vector. So consider vector AB belongs to V. We get the scalar multiplication of this vector with 1. Then our answer will be same vector. So 1 dot AB is equal to A raised to 1 B raised to 1 from the definition is equal to A comma B. So that is 1 dot u bar is equal to u bar for all u bar belongs to V. So all these properties are satisfied for a given set V with given binary operation. Hence V is vector space with given binary operation. If we change the binary operation, then it may possible that given set V may not be vector space. So for any given set may be vector space or not, this depends on the how we define binary operation on a given set. Must remember this statement. Okay, now in the next lecture we discuss some more examples of vector space. All students are requested to practice this example again. After you watch this video, you should try yourself to solve this example. Okay, so we will discuss some more example in the next lecture. Thank you.